Azora is a Spanish firm, private equity investor, mainly focused on real estate, although venturing into other real assets as well. We're a large firm with 200 people, which includes a subsidiary that does all the property management for rented residential for ourselves and for other managers. And we managed at the end of last year, 5.5 billion. So we are, I would say, one of the largest managers and real estate investors independent in the Spanish market. Our pillars of focus, of a strategic focus at Azora, have traditionally been rented residential, tourism and the world of hotels, and in particular the world of vacational hotels, and of course traditional commercial real estate like offices, mainly offices and more logistics. We've always focused on returns and not on size, and that has made us always look at slightly different asset classes, what you would call alternative asset classes. We invested first in rented residential back in 2004. Now is one of the asset classes that is attracting more interest from investors, and within residential, all the new things like co-living, senior living are things where we see tremendous potential. We also pioneered the investment in student housing in Spain and built up the largest platform back in 2012 called Resa. We built up to 9,000 beds and sold it at the end of 2017. But we pioneered that asset class and we generated 30% IRR for our investors. So it's an asset class that we really, really like. And in the world of hotels, we've pioneered the investment in vacational hotels, you know, rather than city hotels, Sun and Beach properties, which is a huge sector in the Spanish market, but very, very much unknown. And through our listed company, Hispania, we created the largest portfolio with 16,000 beds and eventually sold it to Blackstone at the end of 2018. So it's alternative asset classes in operationally intense asset classes and sectors that we like and where we still see.